Okay, folks, so when I say barnyard, I want you to make the noise of one of your favorite animals, okay? So, barnyard. Oh, barnyard. Roar. Barnyard. Meow. How's it going, folks? It's Pat here from Asphalt Green's Recess Enhancement Program, here with another instructional video for you, this time for our game, Move Like an Animal. Before we get into it, though, we of course want to start with a safety check. So, before we start any game and after we finish any game, we always want to make sure that we and our students are washing our hands with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. We also want to make sure that at no point during the game, before the game, after the game, that anybody's hands are going anywhere near their faces, okay? We also want to make sure that if anybody has to cough or sneeze, that they're just dabbing into their elbow, so it only goes into their elbow. We also want to make sure that during the game, before the game, and after the game, and at every point of the day, we're also properly social distancing, okay? So that everybody is always at least 6 feet apart from one another. Once you finish your safety check, though, and you feel confident about moving on, just give me two moos. Moo! Moo! And let's get started. So, as mentioned, the name of the game is Move Like an Animal. What's the name of the game? No, I'm sorry, you don't have to speak like your favorite animal anymore. That's right, it's Move Like an Animal. Now, this is a great game for students from kindergarten all the way up through eighth grade, okay? So students within any age range, students within any ability level range. It's a game that can be played in really any space, okay? What's different about this game, though, is that we will be creating up to eight stations, okay? And students, two or three of them, will be at each station at each point of the game, okay? So they'll be rotating around these different stations. So I say this just so that you can pick an area that's going to allow you to form those stations so that students can perform those activities while being at least 6 feet apart from one another, okay? So some areas where this might be possible on a playground, in a gymnasium, but it could also be the case that students can do this in an auditorium or a hallway or a classroom, okay? Wherever you have the space to set up those stations so students can stand 6 feet apart from one another and perform their activities, okay? So when thinking about safety, if you've picked the correct area, well, students will be able to maintain proper social distance at all times, so they'll be safe on that front. In regards to sharing equipment, well, students won't need to share any equipment whatsoever during this game. All of the activities that the students will complete at each station can just be done on their own, no equipment necessary. All right? So we've got everything covered on the safety front, and I like to think of fun as a byproduct of safety. So since everything's super safe, this game is gonna be an absolute ball. Given that it's also a rep game, though, that means that this game is going to be an extra fantastic ball, all right? But let's get into the details of it, all right? So I can really show you why it's going to be so much fun. And as we always like to do when we get into the details, we're going to rep it out. So we'll start with R ready and talk a little bit about how we can get ready for Move Like an Animal. So, when getting ready for Move Like an Animal, the first thing that you would want to do is map out your play area and designate your boundaries. As mentioned, this game has stations that students will be rotating around. So each station should be set up so that it allows for two or three students, no more, to perform an activity while remaining 6 feet apart from every other student. Okay? Now, depending on your space, you can have up to eight stations. Okay? But it might be the case that your space will not allow for you to have eight stations while maintaining proper social distance. And that is okay. You can cut the stations down to six, five, four, whatever works for you, okay? But it should always be the case that every station is set up to allow two or three students to perform their activity while staying 6 feet apart from every other student. Once you have mapped out your play area, right, you found a space that allows you to create some stations, okay, and you visually marked off where you want those stations to be and where you want the boundaries of the entire play area to be, you can then move into a safety sweep. and you can remove any items in the play area that might pose a safety risk to you or your students. And you can have a think about how you're going to work around any items that maybe can't be moved. Once you finish your safety sweep, you can then lay down the equipment, okay? So you can use cones or tape to mark off each station. And in the center of each station, there should be a cone and there should be a task tent over that cone. And in those task tents, you will place the Move Like an Animal activity instructional sheets, okay, that you have found on our website. And you can decide, you know, you can use up to 8 stations, but you can decide which activity goes into each task tent, all right? So maybe for this day, it's down to 4. Well, you pick your favorite 4 and put them in, okay? But if you have 8, you can put all 8 in, whatever works for you. So once you've laid down all of the equipment, you feel great about the play space, everything seems super safe, the stations are set up so that everyone can remain at least 6 feet apart from one another while performing their activities, well, you can have all of the students line up, maybe a piece of tape that you've laid out on the ground or in a designated spot in between 2 cones, and you can use the attention grabber that I used at the beginning of this video to help you do that. So you can say, when I say barnyard, I want you to make the noise of your favorite animal. So barnyard, oh, barnyard, meow, barnyard, meow. And can I have everybody line up on this tape or in between these cones and stand 6 feet apart from one another so I can explain to you the really fun game we're about to play. Once students have lined up, then you can move into the second portion of the rep model, E, explain. Now, when explaining a game, it's always important to use a loud and clear voice. That way, all students can hear and understand you. You also want to make sure that you're asking students specific questions about the instructions you're giving while you're giving them. That way, you can check for understanding and clarify anything that maybe you weren't super clear on. A few questions we would suggest you ask are, well, how long do you have at each station? And when are you supposed to move to another station? How will you know? Those questions will make a little bit more sense as we go through the instructions for the game. So how about I talk through them now and you follow along on your printed out copy, or you follow along on the copy you found on our website. So the first rule of Move Like an Animal is something you already have students doing, and that is to line up standing 6 feet apart from one another. Once students have lined up though, you can explain to them that a wacky wizard has come along and turned everyone into an animal. And now we have to convince all of the other animals that we are really one of them. You can then tell them the only way we can do this is by moving like those animals. You can then point to all of the different activity stations in the play area. And you can explain to the students that at each station, there is a task tent. And within that task tent is the type of animal we will need to move like, all right? Those task tents will have illustrations and instructions on how to move like an animal. So there will be a bear station, there will be a seal station, and there will be a crab station, all different types of stations. When they are at that station, they will have 60 seconds to move like that animal. Once 60 seconds are up, you can explain that you will give a signal, all right? Could be a whistle, could be an attention grabber, could be, you know, an animal call. And when they hear that, the students will have to rotate, okay? And so they'll have to head to the next station, and they can go in either a clockwise or counterclockwise rotation, whatever works best for you. And then you can just explain that everybody will need to keep moving like an animal until the game ends, until we have convinced all of those animals that we are really one of them. And that is Move Like an Animal. So that's an explanation of the rules for Move Like an Animal. So how about now we move on to play in the rep model and talk a little bit about how we can play the game so students are abiding by those rules, and how we can play the game so as to keep it interesting and engaging for them. Before we do that though, how about we gather on up? So when I say barnyard, you make the noise of your favorite animal. All right, so barnyard, ribbit, ribbit, barnyard, ba, barnyard, chirp, 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 chirp. Great chicken, I know. And how about we gather on up, standing 6 feet apart from one another, all right? Brilliant stuff, folks. Thank you so much for doing that. Okay, so a few tips we have for you for Move Like an Animal. You want to remind students to maintain 6 feet of distance between every other student at all times, okay? Students can get caught up doing their activity that they might forget what's going on around them and get too close to other students. So friendly reminders are always helpful. You also want to practice the signal, right? So say you've decided your signal will be a wolf howl, all right? So, oh, you want to get students comfortable with hearing that signal so they'll know when to rotate, okay? So just practice that, remind students of the signal just so that they always know when it's time to move to another station. You also want to tell students that if any station is, you know, challenging for them and they don't really feel like doing it, well, they can do bunny hops instead, all right? The important thing is to get students active and keep them having fun, okay? And if it means changing one activity to another activity, that is totally okay so long as that student is engaged. Now, if students are looking for a little bit more from this game, well, initially you can have it so that they are doing the noises of the animals while they are moving like them. If they're still looking for more, well, you can lengthen the amount of time that they're spending at each station. So instead of 60 seconds, maybe they're there for 70, 80, 90 seconds, 2 minutes, you know? However long, right? That will be challenging for them, however long to make that happen. Then if students, you know, are still looking for more, well, what you can do is at each station, you can put some tape down, 20 feet of it, and have students do that activity on that tape, going down and back again, right? Something to make it even more challenging, all right? But again, you can add in whatever modifications you would like, so long as it keeps students having fun, keeps them getting active, and of course, keeps them staying safe. So that's the end of our tip list, which means that we're at the end of our rep model and therefore the end of our video. Before we head off though, I think we need to gather up one more time. So when I say barnyard, you make the noise of your favorite animal. So barnyard, ooh, 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 ooh. Barnyard, oh, barnyard, woof, woof. Brilliant stuff, folks. Thanks for gathering on up one last time. Just so I can say thank you. Thank you very much for following along on this video. I hope you found it useful, and I hope you have a great time playing Move Like an Animal with your students. Stay tuned for more videos coming from us over here at Asphalt Green, and we'll catch you the next time.